time and a bounce he will.
I think Modra's fairly high up then.
Oh, unbelievable.
He's almost level with the commentary position. Have a look at this. Can he go up?
Off about two steps, too.
Oh, yeah, just two steps and up.
Here's the bounce. Laid.
I think it's one of those things with Modra that you can't allow him to loop because he takes the one step back and then one step forward and up it goes. You have to get your body in against him to so that he can't get that loop in.
Boundary throw in. After Laid knocked it across the line. Here's Bond in trouble, dragged off the kick. Rosciuto had it knocked away. Stanfield, charged down by Brewer. Stanfield goes again. Was that in the back? Play goes on. Wilson, he loves it in tight towards the outer side. Lyle was there. McLeod behind. An opportunity now. Centres the ball. Tregenza can run to the 50. Not normally the best of kicks. Goes in short, intended for Modra, and he's taken it. That was a good finish. So Modra, about 25 metres out directly in front, going at his fifth, 17th of the season.
It's been a good performance in a losing side. Every time the ball's got near him, the Crows have looked dangerous, but haven't been able to get the ball to the full forward line quite often enough. But Modra's certainly done well when it has.
Goal here. We might find a pulse again. It's good.
They're just keeping the game interesting. Four-goal margin, basically, so with maybe, what, 10 minutes of play to go, it's still probably anyone's game. You'd certainly be on Port, but another goal or two for the Crows. All of a sudden, then, we'll just see what happens.
Tony Modra has kicked five. The Crows just hanging in there at the moment. They need a couple of quick ones. Orman Allen went without, he was bucked off it actually, took his eyes off it. Strong work in the packs here. That's Shane Brewer.
Right.
And against him there is Orman Allen, and he's not happy there, Malcolm Blight, with that little passage, I don't think. So the bounce, Stanfield and Primus. Primus, more experienced ruckman, gets it to Donald Dickey. Now the two-on-one contest out here, the bounce very important, will favour Port. Oh, they both looked at each other. This is Franco, and he takes it over the line on centre wing.
Inside 7 minutes now. Primus, Stanfield. Crows have paid a high price for lacking height today. Stanfield sits on the ball, and the ball up, the attacking side of left centre wing for the Crows. By Rich, calming influence. 17.95, 47,000 today. Primus goes after the ball, was taken high, he'll get the free. Short to Brewer. Brewer's away, on the wing, down towards half forward. The pitchers in front of the tall Laid there. He flicks it back towards Lyle, and Lyle goes across the boundary line. Getting the numbers there, but in some cases, that's almost causing some indecision for the Port. No one left on the bench for the Power. Laid's in front. Stanfield arrives. Fell at their feet. Rosciuto on the way down. Gets the hand pass away. Troy Bob in trouble. Slung. Tyson Edwards hits for the boundary line. Across it goes.
The thing that's impressed me about Port the last 2 weeks, their players run to support and run to the usual position. They're not just running in the hope that their teammate's going to get it. They're actually making sure he gets it by getting over to outnumber the opposition.
The wounded still smiling, and that's a good sign, and why not? Inside of the post now, Burgoyne. Franco slips through across the line eventually. Good pressure by Edwards. Inside the last 6 minutes. And the crowd leaving. John Cale seems to think perhaps he's got it. He's down to the boundary. Burgoyne runs it across again. So
I don't think that's a particular sign with Jack Cale. I think he usually goes down late in the game. I don't think it's any significant victory step or anything like that.
Half forward for Port, or big thump was by Laid. Very strong in the rucks. McLeod to Rosciuto. Shido has found the oar. Bickley couldn't hang on to it. Dickey's after him. Centre of the ground. Nigel Smart's had a dirty day. Braden Lyle, free kick. I'll bring it back. Dennis Rich, one of the most experienced umpires in the competition. I won't say one of the oldest. A real headlock left by Peter Caban.
Didn't need to call on his experience to make that decision.
Lyle out wide. This is Brewer. Now, Brewer's kicking has been a delight to watch today. Again, doesn't belt it hard, just puts it out in front of his teammate on this occasion. It is Lockwood. Lockwood gives it off to Primus. And Crows players are pretty dispirited at the moment. Matthew Primus brings it into the 10-metre area, but a good mark to Ben Hart. Chips it across to Rusciuto. Plays on, finds Bickley. Centre wing this kick, Barty racing after it with Wilson, whose work ethic today has been absolutely outstanding.
11-17 to 9-5. Barty has spent a lot of time on the bench. Primus and Stanfield. Runs true to form. Primus would get it. He didn't. It fell behind. Ormond Allen, a very high up and under, down towards half-forward. Brewer timed it very nicely. They're simply playing the boundary line at the moment. 4.5 minutes to go in showdown number one. And it seems Port Power have bucked the odds. Their record likely to improve to 2-2. Primus worked out of it. Loose ball behind. Dickey. Slips away, there's Dickey, towards the middle, knee peeled off, runs through the middle, goes long down towards Cummings, awkward half volley for him, couldn't control it, Smart's got it, stood up in the tackle, nicely done, got it down to Burgoyne, to Lyle, now a chance for Bond, smothered off the boot by Smart, spins out of trouble, looking for Tregenza, he's got the run of it, tries to poke it to his own advantage, it's socket off the ground, across it comes to Tregenza, well played there by Ormond Allen, now Rusciuto's away. Kicks inside the 50. Modra goes back 20 metres out. He snaps. I think he's got it. The central umpire confers with the goal umpire. It's a goal.
Stephen Daniels arguing with the goal umpire. Whether he felt that he had touched it.
There's no doubt that Patchman, and he probably did touch the ball off the Modra boot. We may see it here, but quite often touch balls are paid goals because it's just too hard for the goal umpire and the field umpire to identify. Let's just see if we can see if it goes off the fingertips.
Oh, yes.
Very hard to tell, but I think from the way that Paxman argued, I suspect it probably was touch, but nevertheless the goal counts.
And Modra's got six in a losing side. It's a pretty good effort. Battling away down there. Oh, that's a free kick to Primus. Oh! My goodness me. Primus can't believe it. The arm was straight across his neck. Anyway, it won't make much difference at this stage, you wouldn't think. Stanfield versus Primus. Knocked back. Here's Rusciuto. Can they get a couple of goals now? The Crows. Modra again! He's going for goal number seven in a terrific performance.
Still 3 minutes to go, Pete.
Yeah, three goals in 3 minutes. Could be two goals and 3 minutes.
This will put a little bit of pressure on. Kicks it. He's right in front, Tony Modra. And he has kicked it. It's his seventh. Great display by the full forward. Now, a lot of pressure on now. Just under 3 minutes lead. Can they get up?
Well, it is a time for composure. I mean, really, I think it becomes a man-for-man situation for Port. Just to get in the centre bounce particularly, make sure every player's covered, just try it again. They got into that challenge before. They slowed the game down for 30 seconds and just rebalanced it. That's what they have to do now.
So couldn't this be pinching it, Dennis?
Absolutely. Full credit, though, to the Crows. Every time Port has taken their foot off the accelerator, the Crows have immediately surged. Primus goes up. Ormond Allen hacks it out wide. Dickey leads in the race. Goes down towards half-forward for his side. Well played by Franco. Knocked it down. Sliding in his Smart. Gets it away. This is McLeod. McLeod goes down towards half-forward. Huskis. Safe hands. The margin is 12 points. 2.5 minutes to go. Adam Huskis.
Late coming back to the centre square. He really just has to run out wide. Make sure it's a long kick out wide.
Don't need to be too cute. The ball goes out very wide. Downs were slipped over. The umpires called it a crow's free. They've got no time. Hart's got the ball. Wants to move it quickly. Goes down towards right half forward. Caven leaders in the clear. Next kick, very important. Caven, a centering kick. They'll contest about 40 metres out. Well played by Mead to knock it away. Lockwood across to Paxman. Paxman kicks it out wide towards the wing. Foot race. Well, beats them across the line. It's Bond and Pregenza. Great defensive fist just moments ago.
Exactly right. I just about to say that Darren Mead put his fist in and saved a certain mark. There's Primus. Oh, he gets his boot to it, but he's put it out in the full.
Clock stops.
Well, there's just under 2 minutes left in this game. The Crows are only 2 goals out of it. You wouldn't believe it. That's Tregenza going forward. Oh, here's Ricciuto. Hook gets in a hand pass. Mark Bickley on the left. Rings it in towards half forward. Mead sets himself. Oh, it's a mark. Barney.
No.
That mark. Now, was it touched or what? Did not go the required distance. Umpire saying it was touched. The umpire saying it was touched off the boot, that kick.
Critical call, isn't it? Critical call. The umpires are out there for though. They've got to make those calls if they see it.
Piper, the bouncer, just outside 50. Still time for the Crows. Johnson hooks it out. Port trying to kick it off the ground. They might get clear here. Hand pass. Comes to Franco. That was good play by Lockwood. They go forward again. A two-on-one contest here. Ben Hart, Nigel Smart, a bit of experience. Hart again. Hart will come back. He's got to come up the middle of the ground. He's got a loose player here. Tyson Edwards, and he marks at centre-half back. But time running out for the Crows.
Under a minute. Chance perhaps of a tie. I don't think they can win now, the Crows. Ricciuto's got it. Plays on immediately. McLeod, we're down to 45 seconds. McLeod goes out wide towards right half forward. Jamison's got it. Jamison about 85 metres from goal. Back to Bickley. The skipper can run to 50. He needs a goal here. Bickley goes long. It slides across the face. Modra over the line and behind. And we're down to 29 seconds. Paxman, the margin, 11 points. The Crows have not gone away. And Port squandered some chances today. Part of the learning curve. Paxman, good kick though, and that should do it. Franco's got it on the outer side. Clock continues to run. We're down to 20. Franco, short one to Brown. So history, great build-up all week, and the record book will show Port Power have won the first showdown in Adelaide. Brown, who played for the Crows, relishing the moment, drives it around the outer side. Wait for the roar on the siren. It's across the line. We'll get the throw in. And there is no more time.